All right, today we're going to check out something that you should all be pretty excited about. It's not only the most affordable, high-quality PCP air compressor that you can get right now, it also does what other PCP compressors do without even breaking a sweat, and that is go to 4,500 PSI. This thing will go to 7,000 PSI, or 480 bar, and it's completely maintenance, oil-free. You just plug it in and do it to it. So we'll take an up-close look at this bad boy. I'll explain everything you need to know. There are some air guns coming out that are going to be running off 7,000 PSI. When I came out with my MCAR video on Airgun Nation, someone was saying, yeah, they're going to come out with a 7,000 PSI version. And I said something back in a comment like, oh, that's crazy because no one would be able to pump it up. But in my mind, I was thinking like, man, this guy's crazy. And then next thing I know, I don't even know how I found these guys, but I found these for sale under 1,000 euros. So you can order stuff directly from AEA Airguns shop, and they'll ship it to the U.S. You get in about 3 or 4 days. They got all kinds of great stuff. They have the entire AEA lineup. Scopes, bipods. Plus, it's run by these guys, and they represent some very prestigious brands, so you never know what you're going to find on their website. You can find them at aeaairguns.shop, and there will be a link in the description as well. There's a lot of these international companies that are shipping to the USA now, including Alturos. I was waiting for the M24 sniper rifle to get here to the USA. It was here the whole time. You just have to order from these guys in wherever they were at. And I believe AEA is actually based in Spain. But regardless, you can order if you're in the USA, and you'll get it really fast. So I went ahead and got everything I need to run a fine PCP air gun, let's say an M4. And the main thing I'm talking about is I got the high pack dry filter, which is more of a high-end filter than I usually run. I usually run the $60 specials from AliExpress. There'll be a link in the description to the AEA website. If you want to grab this compressor, which you probably do, there'll be a link in the description for that as well. The main reason you would want to buy this is because you don't have to oil it. That's huge to me because I never do the maintenance right on these things, and I always end up blowing them up. This one's pretty much dummy proof. As well, the user controls are super easy to use, the interface. This thing's badass. So here we go. The first thing is that if you're in the USA and you're going to run it off a 110-volt wall plug, you're going to need to get the inverter. The inverter's actually going to take that 110 volts and turn it into 220 volts. When you're running the inverter, you're going to select 110 input on the back. And in the front, you're going to plug it into the right side, which says 230 volt out. So the back is your input, the front is your output, and the plug doesn't match up exactly, you just plug it in right like that. Make sure you're on the 230 volt side, because if you run it off 110 volts, it'll ruin the compressor, and obviously void your warranty. This is if you're running it off a battery. There's a battery you can actually get in the back, probably a LiPo. We're going to go to one, since we're running it off AC or 12 volt. So we're going to do that, hit that, boom, look at that. So anytime you want to set the output pressure where it's going to be automatic shutoff, we're just going to hold either one of these down. And I'm going to put mine down to 4,500 PSI. Boom, 4,500, and then just let that stop blinking and it'll be set. So to switch between PSI and bar, I would just hold that for 3 seconds. Then you can change it to bar, change it back to PSI, and we're set right there. You can also do MPA as well. I could do the same thing, switch between Fahrenheit and Celsius. So basically, you hold this down for 3 seconds, and then you're going to be able to scroll through all your different windows. So that second one in the temperature is my cutoff temperature. Let's just go through there again. So we got your PSI we just looked at. That is your current temperature. That's going to be set your cutoff temperature. And that's it. So basically right here in the beginning I just showed you, when you're not in the menu, you hold this down. That's your auto shutoff. Then to set your auto shutoff for your temperature, you would hold this down for 3 seconds. Boom, boom. Now I can make this cutoff at, I want it to cut off at 131. I guess that's That's as low as it goes. All right, well, let's make it 135. And then I'll hit boom. And that's it. These are just readings. That's your voltage and the current. And that is your runtime indicator. So that's how long your compressor's been on. This right here is going to start and stop your compressor. Now, I haven't hooked my hose up yet. So this is going to come out and we're going to put our hose right there. But this is your bleed valve. So you bleed that, tighten it back up when you're ready to compress. And that's it, you guys. It's a pretty simple operation. So apparently in the back, if you take that out, there's probably a place to plug in like a LiPo that's possibly rechargeable. The manual just said that that's available from your dealer. I just got done doing a video on the AEA Harpoon. So it uses these special preloaded cartridges that have your air and your ammo all in one. So here's a little test of the compressor, pumping that baby up to 5,000 PSI. All right, I got my pressure set to 5,000 PSI, and I am hooked up to a 5,000 PSI cartridge. I'm gonna go ahead and go down here and close my bleed valve. Boom. And then I'm just gonna hit this. Well, it's totally badass. So my little contraption did not leak. And check this out. That's pressurized when you have a little dimple right there coming out. So I'm just gonna go down here, bleed the valve. Wow, that's some good dry air coming out of there, no moisture. And now once I've bled my air, I'm good to pull this out. Bam, and I got a pressurized 5,000 PSI cartridge right here. Wow, freaking awesome. So you guys, I already have confirmation there's 7,000 PSI guns on the way, so might as well just buy one of these. This is a trick-ass 220-volt compressor, kicking ass, plugged into 110-volt with my bomb-ass inverter. So freaking got it going on. Can run it off a car battery. You can buy one of these guys right here. If you're gonna put, let's say you got the new M4 or a Mora or an Epic 2, you don't wanna put moist air in there. So you run one of these and you'll be golden. Just make sure, like, I made this little rack and I had my stuff stuck right here. And I actually started it up one time without pulling that out. That's really bad. You gotta have your ventilation on all sides. This wants to suck air from everywhere. Front, back, and everything. I got ventilation on my inverter as well. So yeah, and then when I'm done, just go like this. Boom, and then don't forget to turn your inverter off. Sweet. And this PCP compressor will also pump up your giant carbon fiber SCBA tanks, which stands for self-contained breathing apparatus. Some good brands to look for is Dräger and Scott. So if you have a compressor like this, you can buy a tank that's expired. You don't have to worry about taking it down and getting it hydro tested. You just fill it up. And you can get these tanks for $100. You don't have to spend $700 on a tank. In Europe, they use these for 30 years. In the USA, they stopped certifying them after 15. So I'm sure they're the same tanks. The whole reason I made this little rack was so that I could mount my filter in the vertical position. So here's all the details on how your PCP moisture filter goes together. Step one is we're going to remove the gold end and pop out a spacer that's in here. When you're doing this stuff, be sure to put this at a place where it's not going to fall off and get dirt stuck to that grease right there. So keep that stuff as clean as possible. It said it may be necessary to remove both end caps and pop that spacer out with your little tool that they gave you. Okay, just let's remember which way that went in. So your gold end came off and this was inside it. Again, this is gonna have grease on it. So we're gonna wanna put that somewhere clean. Okay, it says with the silver end in place, I'm gonna take 5 of these black carbon filters and put them in the end. I'll go ahead and use my tool right here to shove them all down so that they look like this. All right, it says use the stick to check the fill level, but I don't understand. Oh, okay, there you go. So you want it, you use that by putting it on the outside. You want it to be to about right there. It says in a well-ventilated area, open your satchel. This is what it looks like. This basically are little beads that soak up moisture. After we put our five carbon filters in there, we're going to pour this in. That is to about right there. Ooh, it's got a little bit more. All right, I got it pretty much perfect right there. So it takes just about exactly one bag. Now it says we're going to take one more carbon filter and put it in on top of that. So after our beads, we're going to go ahead and put this little guy in there, right on top. Smurfic. And then we're going to replace this. Push that in there. Perfect. And then right here is our golden. And in the end of that, we're going to put our little micro filter. Fits right in like that. Then we'll just put that right in there like that. That just kind of bottoms out, but I think that you're sealed off way before you even get that tight. So now both my ends are tight. We got five carbon filters, a bunch of beads, a little spacer and spring, and then our end right here. All right, you guys, this is showing this on a hill right here, but you want to make sure that this tube is mounted in the vertical position. It looks like the silver cap is going to be going from the compressor to the bottom of the tube, and then the top of the tube is the gold cap, and that's going to be coming out and going to your tank or whatever you're filling. It says after 3 months or 10 hours of use, you're going to go ahead and empty the filter and change all that stuff we just put in there. So they give you enough to do that one time. Okay, so this hose right here is definitely has to come out of the gold end. So this big end right there, it's pictured right there. We're going to go ahead and put that on there. And this is definitely then going to be going to basically your fill hose. So I'll go ahead and I'll put this on the end of that, or if you have a fill adapter that's a little more low profile, you can use that as well. I'm not going to use any tape or anything like this. I'm just going to tighten this on there. And we will find out if it leaks. I'm sure it won't. And then the most important thing is that when you're running this PCP filter, you need to have it in a vertical position with a gold end being on top and being the outlet for your air. Definitely don't forget to go check out AEAairguns.shop. They got a great website and they ship to the USA. All right, everybody, that's it for me on this one. When I said that there were 7,000 PSI guns on the way, I didn't mean on the way to me. I meant that the dealers are telling me that there's some that are going to be coming out. So, great time to be an air gunner. All right, everybody. I appreciate you tuning in. Till next week, happy shooting. We'll see you on the next one.